Aguirre. I'm a civil rights lifelong activist and administrator at the Mexican American Civil Rights Institute, also known as MACRI. I'm also an AARP volunteer here in San Antonio. Today, I am joined by Dr. Sarah Zenaida Gould, the interim executive director of MACRI. Dr. Gould is an experienced public historian and museum worker. She was formerly the founding director of the Museo del West Side, a community participatory museum, and the lead curatorial researcher at the UTSA Institute of Texan Cultures, both right here in San Antonio. She also serves on the boards of the Latinos in Heritage Conservation, El Camino Real de los Tejas National Historic Trail Association, and the Friends of the Texas Historical Commission. Dr. Gould serves also on the Council of the American Association of State and Local History. Thank you for joining us, Dr. Gould.
Hi, Barbara. Great to be here with you.
Could you tell everyone joining us today, what is the Mexican American Civil Rights Institute?
Yeah, the Mexican American Civil Rights Institute, or MACRI, as we call it, is a relatively new organization here in San Antonio. And we're dedicated to telling those stories of Mexican American civil rights history. And we want to tell those stories to people of all ages. So from elementary school students, middle school, high school, of course, college students, but then also the general public, adults, people who maybe never got to take a Mexican American studies class in school and who have a thirst for that knowledge or an interest in learning more about that history. Our goal is really to expand understanding of that history, expand. When people hear civil rights, we want them to think about a lot of different things, African-American civil rights, but also Mexican-American civil rights. There are many civil rights movements, both in the past and in the present. And so we're trying to expand that conversation. We're based in San Antonio, but we do, in fact, have a vision for a nationwide project here. So Mexican Americans are everywhere. We're not just here in San Antonio. We're not just in Texas. There are Mexican American civil rights histories in the Pacific Northwest, in the Midwest, in Michigan, and Wisconsin. Right now, there for the last maybe 20 or so years, there's been a booming population of Mexican Americans in what we think of as the American South, like Georgia, New Orleans, places like that. So we want to bring that history to the public and help make that accessible.
And why is it that the Institute, or MACRI, is here in San Antonio? What's noteworthy about San Antonio and about South Texas?
San Antonio has been the birthplace or incubator of so many important Mexican American civil rights organizations, as well as the location of a number of important Mexican American civil rights court cases. So when we think about organizations like Southwest Voter, that was founded here. When we think about MALDEF, Mexican American Legal and Education Defense Fund, that was started here in San Antonio. And there's more. Avance was started here in San Antonio. Of course, a number of important school court cases, as well as voting rights cases for Mexican Americans came out of San Antonio. Some of the organizations that are very well known in Mexican American civil rights history, for example, LULAC. LULAC, the League of United Latin American Citizens, it was founded in Corpus Christi, and yet San Antonio was one of the places where it really rapidly expanded. Same thing with American GI Forum. American GI Forum was founded in Corpus Christi, but rapidly expanded here in San Antonio. So San Antonio, as cultural geographer Daniel Areola has described it, is the Mexican American cultural capital of the United States. And so it's not surprising that so much activity around Mexican American civil rights has happened here in San Antonio. Now, having said that, I don't want to discount all of the Mexican American civil rights history that has happened in other places. So yes, San Antonio is a really critical location for that history, but so is Los Angeles. You know, so is Tucson, Arizona. So, you know, there are other places, and all of those places are deserving of recognition, but it did make sense to start this project here in San Antonio.
I see. What are Macri's current efforts? Like, what is the focus?
Mm-hmm. We have a lot of things happening behind the scenes right now. Right now, we are working to create a digital archive portal, which will be accessible to the public. Hopefully, we'll be able to launch that in mid to late 2021. But that will be a place where people will be able to go online and research Mexican-American civil rights history through a very easy-to-use website, our web portal. We're also currently developing and delivering digital programming around Mexican-American civil rights issues. If you go to our Facebook page, you can find a series of events that are available for the general public. We're also working on and have already started workshops for teachers. So these are teacher workshops for fourth and seventh grade teachers, social studies teachers, I should say, that help show teachers how they can incorporate Mexican-American civil rights history into their curriculum. So here in Texas, for example, our teachers are required to follow the TEKS, or the Texas Educational Knowledge Standards. Those are guidelines that can be supplemented with additional information. And so we have a wonderful curriculum consultant named Dr. Elizabeth Rivas, who's been leading these workshops to demonstrate how Mexican-American civil rights history can be incorporated into TEKS-aligned school curriculum. And we're targeting at this point fourth and seventh graders, because that's when in Texas students take their year of Texas history. So it's a very appropriate time to do that. Across this state and across the US, we're seeing a movement to increase access to ethnic studies, not just in colleges, but at that secondary educational level, you know. And so we're hoping to be a contributor to helping grow that curriculum.
Great. Would you tell people at home where one can learn more about Macri and the Mexican-American civil rights efforts?
Absolutely. The best place to go is our website, which is www.somosmacri.org. You can also visit us on our Facebook page, and you can also visit us on Twitter. We're on Twitter. Yeah.
Great. Is there anything else you'd like to add, anything we haven't touched on yet today that you want to highlight or emphasize?
Yeah, I do want to share that I know a lot of people have their own stories about Mexican-American civil rights history, and we're interested in capturing those stories. If you go to our website, we have a little section at the bottom of the page about how you can share a story. You can put in your contact information, and we can follow up with you. But we're very interested in collecting stories about people's individual experiences with Mexican-American civil rights history. And again, people are the carriers of history. And so we want to bring that to the public. So please feel free to reach out to us.
Dr. Gould, it has been a pleasure having you join us today. And if you would like to learn more about AARP local events, please visit aarp.org/San Antonio. Thank you so much.